This is NITV News with Natalie Armand.
Good evening. It was meant to be a day of respect and remembrance, but police and Aboriginal activists were involved in a violent scuffle at the centre of Anzac commemorations. Protesters were told they were marching illegally, and a senior officer threatened them with a taser as they tried to mark the frontier wars.
The centenary of Anzac challenged by a forgotten history. It didn't start out that way on Anzac Parade in Canberra, with all eyes on current and former defence members taking part in the annual Anzac Day march. At the very end of the ceremony, a group of demonstrators wanted to mark the frontier wars and the violence committed against Indigenous people over the last two centuries. As the English settlers colonised Australia and pushed further inland, conflict was common with Indigenous people, and it's estimated thousands were killed. Those commemorating the frontier wars knew they were marching illegally, and police escorted them along the way.
That's what they're saying, is that, you know, we're trespassing, and that we don't have a permit to march, whereas the RSL have got a permit to march up this esplanade.
The idea was to march peacefully for a few hundred metres and stop at the police blockade.
When we get up there, we will be respectful. We'll stay on the, maintain the high moral ground, and we just spread across, right across that street, up there, and just hold the banners and flags.
Once the group was stopped, the chanting began.
It is my country, don't you chant? Tell me this chatter. It's not. Where's this treaty with me? You have no paper.
The police said certain protesters were now breaching the peace.
And we explained to you, this land is under the control of the RSL at the moment.
Well, that's fine.
If you're not part of an authorised march, they do not let you on
well,
there.
Well, okay, I'm a member. I am also a member of the RSL.
And then the uneasy standoff exploded. As police tried to remove this man, another police officer is pushed out of the way as people tried to stop the police arresting protesters. Then a senior police officer pulled out his taser and threatened Lawrence Coughlin, the keeper of the flame at the Aboriginal tent embassy. With a crowd building and many cameras, the police called for backup and asked marchers to move on.
That's not the 100th anniversary of Anzac Day.
Well, we tell the people to be silent.
No.
We tell them to be silent.
No, you tell them to be silent and you can move away, thanks, OK?
With the scuffle over, police threatened to seize the NITV News camera, saying the vision was now evidence.
You haven't hassled anyone else for their footage, so I would like to leave now, as I believe I'm free to do. If you have reason to arrest me, you might as well get it over and done with, but I'm going to be recording the whole thing.
No, unfortunately, stupidity is not illegal.
And police questioned why NITV News was filming the march.
So that's being used for a private purpose?
Would appear so.
That's a bit of a misuse of Commonwealth...
No, officer, it isn't.
It is. It's got a Commonwealth...
I work for National Indigenous Television News. I was covering an Indigenous march for
Which would make you a Commonwealth employee.
Indeed.
Ergo... Would you be behaving in contravention by the fact that Commonwealth asset is being used for private personal purposes?
As I say again, it's not for private purposes. This is going into a news story. It's part of our Anzac Day coverage.
Oh, really?
What would that story be? Australian taxpayer pays us to tell the stories of Indigenous Australia.
Myles Morgan, NITV News.
In the end, they did not seize our footage, but our reporter has just received a response from the Federal Police. They confirmed the deployment of a taser, saying that all incidents where ACT policing officers utilise a use of force option are reviewed in accordance with AFP governance, and we'll put the complete statement on our website. NITV has also called on the Federal Police to apologise, and we have lodged a formal complaint for further investigation. The full exchange between the police and our reporter is on our Twitter and Facebook pages. And while that march did end badly, there was some good news out of Canberra on Anzac Day. There was a record turnout at the Indigenous Dawn Service in bushland behind the Australian War Memorial. Hundreds of people, including serving Indigenous members, came to pay tribute to the sacrifice of First Nations men and women in war. It was a more informal service with a didgeridoo and musical performances, but a serious message.
The Anzac legend has a black face. We own this legend too.
I know at least 50 men who served on Gallipoli. 12 of them are still there. The other 38 that went to France and Belgium and Palestine, seven of them are still in France and Belgium.